Hi everyone, how you doing? It's Mark back again. This is How We Did It, Volume 11. And this time we're going to be looking at drum breaks, famous ones, but one in particular called the Think Break, which is by Lyn Collins. And in line with that, we're also going to be looking at ADOR, who is quite a famous rapper because of how he was sampled, but also has one of the sort of most famous tunes in the hip-hop canon, produced by Pete Rock, and also looking at Michael Jackson's eldest sibling called Rebbie Jackson, who, to be honest with you, I'd never heard of until I heard a track and thought, I wouldn't mind messing around chopping that up. Okay, so I'm going to start by telling the story of the Lyn Collins Think Break, which I know that the majority of people here who are music-wise will know a lot about, so please excuse me, but there's some really massive tunes that have used it, and it sort of charts a history of hip-hop, house music, breakbeat, and then drum and bass have all used the Think Break. Okay, so the Think Break is by Lyn Collins. Let's have a listen to it. Written and produced by James Brown and released in 1972. Here we go. Okay, beautiful, lovely keyboard playing, all sorts of great funk production going on there, and all live band as well. And basically, you can hear there's a very predominant sound in there. That's a tambourine being played very loud up front, probably, you know, in the studio right up to a mic. And that's what I want to call the tambourine meme, okay? So I have this thing about comparing how samples are like old versions of what memes are visually, okay? How people use the same things over and over again to, that are, you know, like viral, aren't they, okay? Because this break, this track here by Lyn Collins has been sampled 2,000 times, probably more, okay? It breaks down three times, or four times. There's four parts of the song that have been used. Let's have a listen to them all. Okay, so Lyn Collins Think Break. Probably Clyde Stubblefield on the drums. Please correct me if not. Okay, that's the first one. We'll listen to it again. Second one. Third one. This is the tambourine meme. And then finally. Okay, so let's have a look at the history of that sample. So it really started getting used in around 86, 87. Wild Pitch, of course, which I keep mentioning. Latee, This Cut's Got Flavour. People claim that might have been the first use of it. Here's some of the tracks that I was playing at the time that use it, okay? So, Roxanne Shante, one of hip-hop's greatest female vocalists. I think she was very much predominantly produced by Marley Marl, but I don't know if he did this beat in particular. But Go On Girl by Roxanne Shante. Listen to this tambourine meme. I want you to listen to that tambourine that's in this break so you'll hear it if you can't hear anything else. Okay, great, Roxanne Shante. It's quite funny to listen to the reverbs they used back then. Pretty cheap ones, to be honest. Okay, so now let's flip it, okay? So that's what you'd sort of call hip house from the time. Now, this is going into like proper cool underground house music. Work It to the Bone. Check this out. This used the Think Break as well.
Come on, let's work.
Tambourine meme. Okay, keep it moving. Okay, so this is a little bit of a forgotten tune. Tony Scott, That's How I'm Living. This is a sweet produced tune, also using the Think Break. Ready? can almost feel like I'm in The Man Alive in Manchester listening to that. Okay, so now this one is one of my favourite tunes of all time as regards sampling, and it came off the British sort of proto-rave scene. Blapps Posse, okay, Don't Hold Back. Very strangely, the guy who made this track used to play tennis down the street, and I got talking to him about it one time. Big, big tune, Blapps Posse, Don't Hold Back, the instrumental, breaks upon breaks. Here we go. Okay, let's wind it forward to the beginning of what was at the time called jungle, okay? So the use of this this same think break. Remember, we're concentrating on this think break by Lyn Collins from 1972. It kind of forms a backbone along with the Amen break and Funky Drummer as like the biggest tunes ever to be sampled thousands and thousands of times. Like I sort of call them memes. This is the tambourine meme, okay? This is a close one to me, love it. Leviticus Burial. This is when, before drum and bass became drum and bass, jungle was called jungle, and it had a lot stronger connections to the rare groove scene and a lot stronger connections to ragga and dancehall. So you'd get like rare groove samples and then you'd get dancehall samples, and then basically you would have something like Burial made, and this uses Mademoiselle by Foxy, which is a great rare groove tune. Check this out. Look for that think break again, okay? Wait for the bass line on this one. Wait for the sample, eh? The Foxy sample by Mademoiselle. Okay, so there's the Mademoiselle Foxy break, which is a rare groove tune, and then there's a vocal in there that goes big, bad and heavy, and then I think the producer had his girl, his sister sing in a kind of street soul style over the top in the studio. Okay, so that was a big tune. So that's just a little brief history of the Think Break by Lyn Collins, James Brown produced. Okay, so what I've done is I've taken it from one of my favourite records from 1988, which is on Next Plateau Records, which had Ultramagnetics and everything. And I have sampled this tune, which I presume a lot of you will already know. Sugar Bear, Don't Scandalize Mine.
Before, once more, time after time. Don't scandalize mine.
Cool. This guy did one record and then disappeared. He was a cool rapper. Okay, so let's have a listen to the instrumental so we can hear that think break in there on its own. Actually, what are they called again? It's David Byrne in there, isn't it? Once in a Lifetime.
Experience.
Okay, so I've taken that. What else have I taken? I want to talk a little bit about ADOR now, okay? So he's a guy from Washington Heights who moved to Money Earning Mount Vernon, as Pete Rock and C.L. Smooth called it. And He's a really good rapper. Did Let It All Hang Out, which we'll have a listen to in a minute. I ended up remixing Let It All Hang Out with Steve as Ryan Christian later on in the day when they tried to relaunch it after Fatboy Slim took Wild Child and made that massive Renegade master tune out of it. So we're going to get into that. I've taken similar parts. Let's have a listen to Let It All Hang Out first, which was my personal first introduction to California Soul. So let's have a listen to this. Pete Rock at his best. He's a great MC, ADOR. Pete Rock on the beats there, SP1200 rocking hard. Okay, so let's tell the story of what I'm doing here mixing to make this track. Now, this is a track called The Centipede's Behavior, which I've made using the Think break. Excuse me, I've caused a bit of a riot down here. But, so I was telling you about this Rebbie Jackson track. It's called Centipede. It was written by Michael Jackson for his older sister, just after I think he did Off the Wall or around the time of Thriller. It was like maybe 83 or something. I knew nothing about it, okay? But it's a really cool break. Let's have a little listen to the break on its own, okay? Very electronic production, and you can really hear that it's Michael Jackson's style because of the way he, you know, just feels the chords and everything. So let's have a listen to the break I'm going to use, okay? This is Centipede. I mean, who wouldn't want to sample that when you hear that for the first time? Okay, so that's Centipede by Rebbie Jackson, okay? Let's listen to it with the Sugar Bear drums, which are from Think, in there together, okay? Keeping the tangerine meme alive, eh? Tambourine meme. It's a tangerine dream. That's where that must have come from. Okay, who were a prog rock band of the early 70s? Okay, so that's the beat I've got going, okay? So let's tell a little... I started building up on this, right? I put some extra drums on top of that to make it pop, okay? There's very simple little bits I put in there, but yeah, but they colour everything around the Think break, so it's not just that, okay? Okay, so next, I needed an intro, right? So I took a little bit of Schooly D from one of my favourite tracks of the time, was Put Your Feelers On, and that came, seriously, this is like one of the... This album, like, was mind-blowing to me at the time, because I think, you know, this is sort of regarded as the first gangster rap album, but for me, it was just sounded like no music I'd ever heard. It was just a drum machine with loads of reverb on it, and Schooly D being rude, and then this DJ called Code Money, who I think was 15 at the time, going absolutely nuts. I have to make sure I don't land on swearing, so beware, everyone. Took a little bit where he just goes 1, 2, 3, 4 from here. I gotta say it before I go, and it'd be like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. You know we rock, we roll, we jam and we mix. Okay, he's about to rhyme mix with something. So yeah, a bit of Schooly D, because I remember I'm looking for little bits of fruit to put around all of this main body of music here. So then the next thing, and I can't, as Portrait of a Masterpiece by the Doc, okay, the DOC, he was part of NWA, in my opinion, the best rapper out of all of them, and he shows it on Portrait of a Masterpiece, but he had a car accident and did his voice box in, so he sort of left the scene, but amazing guy. And so CJ McIntosh, who was a big house producer at the time, he did a remix of this for Pete Tong, I think. And let me just take everything out so I can talk about this. So he sampled Sound of Philadelphia. I can't remember which tune it is. Anyway, I've used it at the beginning. This little bit here, which is taken as a sample. Okay, that's Love Something. Sorry, I've forgotten what that's called. Maybe you can help me out there, people. Okay, so what else did I use? So we're going to get to hearing this in a minute, okay? I used... that was the Portrait of a Masterpiece. Masters at Work did a remix of Dancing in Outer Space, okay? And there's a little a cappella at the end of that. These are why, if you want to make tunes like I do, then get stuck in, go and buy loads of a cappellas out of second-hand shops, and then you can start constructing different versions of things and just have fun, basically, okay? So the Masters at Work one is a guy going into outer space, and it's going to help me build a verse leading up into the chorus. Well, let's have a look, let's have a listen to the origins of Wild Child, Renegade Master, okay? This is produced by Marley Marl, so this was after he'd done the Pete Rock tune, and this is 93. Okay.
One for the trouble, two for the time. 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 One for the trouble, two for the time.
All right, vocals, samples. Okay, there you have it. That's all of it. Okay, so Wild Child took that first. And I think we're about right to stick this all together. So I've got Rebbie Jackson, The Think Break, ADOR, Masters at Work, Schooly D, and my own little bit of production. We're going to make this all pop. It's called The Centipede's Behaviour. Let's call it The Renegade Centipede instead. That's a better name now. Okay, here we go. From the top. The Masters at Work bit, yeah?
I wanna dance in outer space.
Jackson producing his sister there, yeah? So that's the Centipede Break. Okay, so that's it. That's using the Think Break. It's a short one this time. This is how we did it. Volume 11, The Think Break, Centipede's Behaviour, ADOR, Masters at Work. God, the whole lot. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. It's a good one to break dance to, that one. I reckon, even though I can't do that, maybe body popping. Make sure you wear strong socks if you're doing it on the kitchen floor. It's been Mark Ray, and I'm out. Peace.